Coming in hot on this episode of Under the Wire, we'll recap the first Spartan Ultra of the 2019 season that went down this past weekend in the tri-state, and finally, the first Trifecta weekend of the year, and we'll also take you to one of the most scenic venues Spartan has to offer. Let's go. Spartans, what's going on? I'm Mitchell Renz from Chat Sports, and welcome to our fourth episode of Under the Wire. The Garden State, New Jersey, hosted the first Spartan Ultra of the 2019 calendar this past weekend, which means it's the first qualifying race for the 2019 Sweden Ultra Championship. If you don't know, an Ultra race is one of the toughest Spartan has to offer, made up of 30 grueling miles and 60 obstacles. It's the epitome of endurance racing, and in case that wasn't enough at this particular venue, Spartans were subjected to an elevation change of more than 10,000 feet in both incline and decline. I'm tired. Tired just thinking about it, competing in an Ultra. But I want to hear from everybody who's watching. So if you've competed in a Spartan Ultra, I want you to tag your race partner. So if you're watching this on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, anywhere that you see this video, tag your race partners below. Now, Spartan Ultra is just another day in the office for Seattle's third place finisher, Rea Kolbl, and 2018 Ultra World Champion, Ryan Atkins, who both showed up to represent the Spartan elite. But before we get to the tri-state results, let's take a look back at the Ultra World Championship last year in Iceland, where Atkins dominated not only the field, but his own physical and mental abilities.
Of pushing and pushing and pushing, just like my body just collapsed. All right, I'm gonna go lie down.
The first Spartan Ultra of the year kicked off at 6 a.m. Man, that is early. At Mountain Creek Resort in Vernon, New Jersey, and to no one's surprise, it was Ryan Atkins who broke away from the pack. Coming off his first place finish of the year in Seattle last month, he kept his streak alive in New Jersey, finishing the 30-mile course in an absurd time of 6 hours, 1 minute, and 34 seconds. Hot off her first podium finish of the 2019 season in Seattle, Rea Kolbl was determined to keep her momentum going, and that's exactly what she did. Finishing first in the women's field, and wait, get this, fourth overall. Kolbl clocked in just shy of 7.5 hours. In last year's New Jersey event, Kolbl was forced to exit the race due to hyperthermia. Her performance this past weekend was a personal redemption. Kolbl said, "New Jersey and I are at peace now. Only one failed spear throw and 60 obstacles? Yeah, I'd say that's pretty darn good." Atkins and Kolbl weren't the only Spartans in on the action. Lindsay, Webster, and Ryan Kempson kept their legs warm in the Beast, running alongside the Ultra competitors. The Mountainous Beast was just a little preview of what's to come just 2 weeks in the first Beast of the U.S. National Series in Big Bear. Kempson snagged the top spot in the men's, finishing the 13-mile, 30-obstacle Beast with a time of 2 hours and 22 minutes. Webster following suit in the women's field at 2 hours and 47 minutes. Josh Reininger and Luke Bosick finished second and third for the men's, while it was Heather Golnick and Callie Schwakart for the women's at 2 and 3. Here's what Lindsay Webster had to say about her performance in New Jersey.
It was a good day out there today. Won the New Jersey Beast, definitely not the Ultra Beast. Don't envy them. yeah, really gnarly course. Tons of fun though. Just sort of transitioned to the hill training after Seattle, and then I'm gonna spend, obviously did this race, which I think will be excellent training for it.
The hills were definitely a lot like the Big Bear hills, so I practiced power hiking, transitioned to running, and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to go a little bit faster in Big Bear.
Yeah, I think it was a great prep. This is like basically an East Coast Big Bear, so yeah, it was great prep and I'm stoked.
As pretty as the mountainside of the Garden State can be, it's got nothing on one of our favorite Spartan Race locations, Orte, Italy. Truly taking advantage of its location and historical landmarks, this venue proves to be up there as one of the top bucket list worthy destination races. Not to get carried away by its good looks, this event was a busy one. With this being a trifecta weekend, a sprint, super, and beast were all available for racing in Orte. The beast counted as stop number two in Italy's national series. Slovakia's Janka Popova placed first for the women, while Spain's Alberto Soleil did the same for the men's. Italy's own Eugenio Bianchi placed second in the men's competition, marking his 50th podium finish of his career. The locals showed off their pride, chanting and holding up signs reading 50 during the award ceremony. What an accomplishment. Speaking of trifectas, which type of race is your favorite? So if you're watching this on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, anywhere that you see this video, I want you to comment below. Type S for sprint, type sup for super, or type B for beast. We're keeping it short and sweet this episode, but coming up, a major weekend around the globe for Spartan. We've got national and regional championship series races in six countries, including Australia, the Philippines, the UK, France, Spain, and of course, right here in the good old US of A, as Montana hosts the first race in the US Mountain Series. Spartans, you know the deal. Follow Spartan Race on Instagram for sights and sounds around the globe throughout the weekend. And then we'll be back in a few weeks with a brand new episode where we'll recap all of those events and more. All right, Spartans, I'm Mitchell Renz from Jat Sports, and this has been Under the Wire.